Welcome to this presentation on the neck, part one. Here we have the introduction to the lecture, and two areas are highlighted, and these happen to be the triangles of the neck. So if you'll continue on this journey with me, we'll learn more about these geometric configurations. So again, two colored areas here. We have the area in blue. This is one of the major triangles of the neck, and then the one located posteriorly is the second triangle of the neck. Because of their anatomic relationships, the one in blue is referred to as the anterior cervical triangle. The muscle that we see here as a major boundary is the sternocleidomastoid, and it will separate this anterior triangle from the one that lies posterior. That then leads us to this green-colored region, which represents the posterior triangle of the neck. Its posterior boundary is seen right along here, and that represents the trapezius muscle. Each triangle can be divided into smaller parcels or subdivisions. So when we look at the anterior triangle, this one's more complicated, we can see this region just inferior to the mandible and bounded by the stylohyoid muscle here and the anterior belly of the digastric. This area represents your submandibular triangle. Lying inferior to the anterior belly of the digastric muscle is a small region or triangle called the submental triangle. Its inferior boundary would be at the level of the hyoid bone that we see here, and then another boundary would be the midline of this particular region. Your third subdivision to the anterior triangle is your carotid triangle. And here we can see the stylohyoid muscle, and here we see the anterior belly of the omohyoid, as well as the sternocleidomastoid forming its boundaries. The fourth and final subdivision of the anterior triangle is referred to as the muscular triangle. Its boundaries would be your anterior belly of the omohyoid, the inferior portion of the sternocleidomastoid shown here, and then it would run to the midline of the neck. And the upper limit of this area would be your hyoid bone. The posterior triangle is less complex with respect to its subdivisions. Here we see the occipital triangle, the posterior triangle identified. Its boundaries are the sternocleidomastoid. Here you see the posterior belly of your omohyoid, and then you see the trapezius. The second and final subdivision of your posterior triangle is the omoclavicular triangle. This small area here, and you can see it's bounded by the posterior belly of the omohyoid, hence omo in the prefix. This boundary here is the clavicle, hence clavicular as the suffix. And then the third and final boundary to this triangle is going to be your sternocleidomastoid.